Hi friends, welcome to 6th lesson on batch scripting. Today we will continue learning about advanced command in batch scripting. If you guys haven't seen my previous video on batch scripting, I will highly recommend you guys to go and check that out. The link is in the description. So today we will work with iterate batch command. That's one of my favorite batch command to work with. So let's start out by opening the text editor. Here I'm using Notepad++ and we'll create a batch executable file here. The iterate batch command. This batch command displays or sets the attribute of file in the current directory. So the syntax for this will be attribute and file name. If you don't give the parameter attribute, then this batch command will display the attribute of file in the current directory. And if you give the parameter attribute, it will set the attribute of file in the current directory. So let's see how it works. So let's create the basic structure for our script at the rate echo off. To stop the echoing, pause to hold the screen, create a bat executable file .bat and save that. So let's say here I want to see the attribute of this file. So get the path first, write the command attrib and the file name. Here I'm not giving the attribute parameter, so it will display the attribute of file. So save that, run the file. Here you can say A has been assigned to this file. A is basically used for archive. The archive attribute is used for backup. When a file is created, the archive bit is turned on, and when a program copies the file, the archive bit is turned off. The file attribute exists so that you or a program you are using, even the operating system itself, can be granted or denied particular rights to a file or a folder. So if I want to give a read-only attribute, so let's see how we can do that. So we just need to add plus R. Here R stands for read-only. Save that, double click on it. It says press any key to continue. To display the attribute for the file, you again need to use the same command without attribute parameter. Here it says read-only has been assigned. So come here, open the file. That's fine, that's working fine. And read-only has been assigned. So to remove the read-only parameter, you just need to replace plus R with minus R. Save that. Again, you can see the read-only parameter has been removed. So that was all for this video. In the next video, we will learn about the find command. Thanks for watching the video. We'll see you guys in the next session. Thank you.